So this question comes from Ed Dev. Is there money to be made in machine learning in the future? Question mark. Would you recommend Google's TensorFlow framework? So is there money to be made in machine learning? Absolutely. Absolutely. Does a corgi crap? Does a chihuahua bark? Yes, there is going to be a crap ton of money to be made in machine learning. So basically what machine learning is, it's the whole idea of machines actually being able to teach themselves. So the way that we code and we teach machines, robots, computers now, is we have to tell them everything. Everything is an if, then, else type of statement. The problem is, then, is when the device goes out in the real world, especially things like autonomous vehicles, there are simply millions and possibly billions of situations that you wouldn't even think about to come up with what the response should be. And so as we start putting machines out in the real world, they have to start being able to learn on their own. So basically, they have to be given failure. What defines a failure, what defines a success, and then they need to go out and they need to learn how to do things so they get successes instead of failures. So machine learning is huge. I mean, machine learning is the next 10, 20 years at least. It's very interesting. I was talking to the CEO of Carbon.ai. They do arm robots, they do robotic arms. And so with them, they have this whole machine learning component built in. So every single robotic arm that gets deployed into to the real world all communicates back to a cloud server so that all the arms are literally learning how to function more efficiently and better from each other. And so we've seen this before with like Tesla. So Tesla has a way for all the Tesla cars to communicate back with the Tesla servers. And so that's where they talk about with the Tesla Autopilot. Every day the cars get better, they get safer. The reason is because they're all learning from each other in a way that you just simply can't do as a person. We just could never code in that many situations. The question is where do you start with this? Where do you start with this? I don't know. Like you're asking whether or not you should go and you should look at Google's TensorFlow framework. Of course, if it's Google, it's probably a relatively good thing. But I would say probably take a look at something like Udacity. One of the issues you run into whenever a technology is relatively new is that there's a thousand ways to skin a cat. And so sometimes instead of focusing on something that's vendor specific, it's better to go and actually learn from an overall like educational environment to learn how things work. So Udacity, I've talked about Udacity before. They are not a sponsor. They have never paid me a dime. They've never given me anything at all. But I talk about Udacity a lot because I've said before, that's so good. I can't compete with these folks. But they do have their own machine learning engineer nano degree. The program will teach you how to become a machine learning engineer and apply predictive models to massive data sets in fields like finance, healthcare, education, and more. Timeline is 6 months, and they give you the information here. I would argue, if you just want to go out there and you want to learn TensorFlow, God bless. I mean, I guess. But I would argue with most people when you're new into a field, like what something like TensorFlow is good for, like what learning this is good for, is when you already basically know what machine learning is, you already know basically what problem you're trying to solve, and then somebody says, "Hey, you know that problem you're trying to solve, I bet TensorFlow would allow you to solve that problem." And so then you go and you just learn TensorFlow specifically. So that's good. If you're already a technology professional, if you already know basically the problem that you're trying to solve and more or less how you're trying to solve the problem, and then this is simply a tool where you go, oh, okay, yeah, this tool will solve the problem. On the other hand, if you're a noob or you're trying to get into the field, trying to learn a specific problem product, the problem is you may just learn the wrong damn product. There may be 10 different products out on the market, and you pick the one to learn that nobody cares about. And that's what you don't want to have happen. Remember, with resources, you have the two resources you have are time and money. And what I see with a lot of new people is that they actually waste too much time. They think, oh, I don't have any money, but I have all the time in the world. Well, remember, time is still a limited resource. The more time you spend learning crap that you're never going to use, that's less time you're spending using learning things that you could actually do something with. So I would argue just go, I think the nano degree programs are something like $200 a month. So if you really want to learn machine language learning, this would cost you like something like $1,000, $1,200. I think this would be a far better investment for you because then you get an idea of what people actually care about. And then in the future, then once you finish something like this nano degree, then you can figure out whether or not you should learn the TensorFlow framework. So that's my thought on it. Machine learning, if you like machine learning, go for machine learning. There's no doubt that machine learning right now is the future. Machine learning, they keep trying to throw VR at us. They keep trying to throw augmented reality at us. They keep trying to throw wearables at us. Most of that crap isn't going to go anywhere. Machine learning is where the real money's at. So definitely go after it. I would argue you should go with Udacity.